for his opening address.
The Right Honourable Yvette Cooper, Secretary of State for the Home Department, Your Excellency Graham Beaver, Director General of the NCA, Your Excellencies, Distinguished Ministers and Chief of Police, Head of Delegations, Ladies and Gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good morning. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the 92nd Interpol General Assembly here in Glasgow, in Bonnie, Scotland. I would like to extend my gratitude to our host country for organizing this significant event. The UK's commitment to international cooperation and its unmatched law enforcement capabilities have been invaluable in our collective efforts to combat transnational crime. Before we begin, I would like to take this moment to thank the Executive Committee, Vice Presidents, and delegates for their leadership and commitment to policing excellence, neutrality, respect, integrity and teamwork. Over the past 3 years, the Executive Committee engaged in constructive, productive discussions across key areas central to the organization's mission. Our key focus has been to support the Interpol vision and mission and strategy, and to guide and support the Secretary General. I would also like to thank the Secretary General, Jürgen Stock, for his service to Interpol. Over the past decades, Secretary General Stock has led to our organization with dedication and commitment to excellence. His time in office has brought major progress in international police cooperation and a strong commitment to improving global security. Dear Secretary General, we are grateful for your contributions and years of dedicated service. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to introduce Mr. Valdisi Urquiza from Brazil, who has been proposed by Interpol's Executive Committee as a candidate to the next Secretary General of Interpol. Should his candidacy be endorsed by the General Assembly, Mr. Urquiza would become the first Secretary General from Latin America in our organization's history. Mr. Urquiza represents the future of Interpol, a diverse, tech-forward organization committed working with its 196 member countries to ensure a safer world for all. His leadership will be key to foster an inclusive environment where voices from all regions are heard. Mr. Urquiza, we are pleased to have you by our side today. Excellencies, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, as we gather here today, it's essential to reflect on the year we have had. Last year's General Assembly marked the centenary of Interpol. It was a milestone that underscored our commitment to global policing. The centenary celebration were not just commemoration of our past achievements, but also a confirmation of our dedication to evolving and updating and adapting the changes of modern-day policing. During the last General Assembly, we took significant steps to shape the future of the organization. We approved the draft resolution regarding the Interpol's Vision 2030, ensuring that we are prepared to tackle the constantly changing faces of crime and modernizing our data processing to strengthen our internal system and help us to support member countries more effectively. We also approved resolutions to enhance our operational and strategic partnership with member countries and partner agencies. Ladies and gentlemen, the criminal landscape continues to evolve, and we must stay ahead of it. From the rise of organized crime, drug trafficking and terrorism, to climate change and migration challenges, our ability to adapt and innovate is crucial. This year's General Assembly presents an opportunity to member countries to engage in fruitful conversation, share intelligence, and enhance collaborative strategies. Ladies and gentlemen, the Executive Committee sets principles and measures to achieve the organization's goals, review and approve the annual activities and financial policy, and provides guidance between assembly sessions. Cross-border collaboration is one of the pillars of our efforts, and it's the only through working together that we can effectively combat transnational crime. If Interpol is the global body of the international policing, the member countries are the heartbeat, and the Executive Committee is the brain. I want to emphasize that the important role of the Executive Committee in the organization's governance. As the decision-making supervisory body with representatives from Interpol's regions, the Executive Committee works all year round to implement the Interpol strategy that benefits you. I want also to highlight the Executive Committee's representatives, you, and they are the supreme body of Interpol's, who represented by the professionals you have chosen to ensure accountability and transparency within the organization, oversees the implementation of the initiatives and programs, and advocate for the interests and needs of each and every one of our 196 countries. Ladies and gentlemen, you have and continue to support the Executive Committee and the General Assembly in some of the working groups that help facilitate their mandate. We are thankful for your support. Today, we bid a farewell to 9 members of the Executive Committee who were chosen by you. I assure you that you have chosen people who best represent you and your region, and may hope that that you're going to choose always the best to serve you and the organization. Thanks to the support of the Executive Committee, the General Secretariat, and the various team involved. Ladies and gentlemen, Interpol continues to evolve and reinvent itself to remain relevant and efficient across time and geographies. We share our vision for a safer world with organizations like Ameripol, Afripol, AMAC, Europol, Frontex, and the United Nations. By collaborating and sharing information, we can continue to create a more effective approach to combating crime. These partnerships allow us to combine strength and resources, enabling us to make the world a safer place for all. Since my election I have worked with my Interpol peers to develop and deploy and enhance solutions to better support law enforcement personnel around the world. Under the Executive Committee's directions, we have greatly improved our digital infrastructure to boost our global security operation, enabling real-time information sharing and collaboration. Our secure global police communication system, including the Interpol Metaverse and other tools that, like the AVA, Interpol's artificial intelligence tool, are available to support operations and capacity buildings. This year, we have also deployed our Interpol mobile device in several countries. This helps us to enhance our ability to share intelligence swiftly and securely. Ladies and gentlemen, data is the core of what we do. It is the information that we share via our 19 database that enables Interpol to support countries around the world, regardless of their size. We are closing this quarter with 1.5 million hits against the databases, a significant 32% increase compared to the same time period in 2023. Database searches increased by 8%, bringing our records to 151 million. I urge you all, member countries, to continue using these databases to support their operations and to keep updating them to strengthen the intelligence efforts of your peers worldwide. Now, is it possible to create a truly effective Interpol without embracing diversity and inclusion? How can we future-proof our organization without fully reflecting the diversity of our global membership? This question drives our commitment to inclusion and representation. With the support of the Executive Committee, we have worked tirelessly to prioritize diversity and inclusion. Our experience has shown that our commitment paying off. No more than ever, it's crucial to foster a more inclusive and effective Interpol to not only future-proof the organization, but also to create a safer world. Since my election, I promised during my campaign, Interpol has prioritized diversity and inclusion, reflecting its global membership of 196 countries. Financial assistance for secondment has been implemented to support officers from underrepresented countries. Today, I am proud to say that diversity at our headquarters has grown from 108 nationalities in 2021 to 134 in 2024, with a more balanced distribution of managerial positions globally. Additionally, the Executive Committee approved Interpol's Excellence Award to acknowledge and promote your achievement. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to highlight a few of our collective achievements from the past year. In 2024, Interpol made a significant progress in our operations. Over the past 3 years, Interpol has carried out 208 global police operations. Just last year, operation led to the arrest of 18,000 suspects, the seizure of 244 tons of drugs with $5.8 billion, and more than 10,000 illegal weapons and illegal medical equipment worth over $560 million. Operations also led to the dismantling of 20 organized crime groups that recovered over $406 million from all of their activities. and almost 7,000 bank accounts and 52 crypto wallets frozen from just one operation. Of course, none of these achievements would have been possible without you. I would like to extend my deepest gratitude to the brave women and men in this room and across the world who have dedicated their lives to protecting civilians. We are thankful for you and for your service. Ladies and gentlemen, Interpol here to serve all of its member countries. We are here to support everyone. No country is too big or too small. No country is rich or too poor. We are all equal. We are here for everyone and for you. Thank you, merci, gracias, and shukran.